Good morning, and welcome to Mount Olive Baptist Church. I am Dr. Adrian E. Weidman. I'm the pastor here. Our focus here at Mount Olive Baptist Church is that we enter to worship, but we leave to serve. My prayer for all of you this morning is that something may be prayed, something may be sung, something may even be preached that will change your life. Come, let's see what the Lord has in store for us this morning.
Yes. I've been through the fire. I'm yours, Lord. Everything I've got.
Uses of fire.
Much like anything in the world today, fire can help you, or it can hurt you. Depending on your purpose for the fire, it can make things stronger or make things weaker.
Yes, sir.
Depending on your purpose of the fire, it can be used to light your way, or the smoke can be used to darken your path.
Yes.
It can be used to keep us alive, or it can be used to take someone's life.
Yeah.
The fact still remains that in your life you will run into some fiery situations.
Yeah.
But for those who can withstand the heat from the flame, those that can keep pressing on through the fiery dark, those that can continue to keep walking through the shadows of the valley of death, those that continue to keep pressing through the smoke-filled areas of your life, you can look towards heaven and say, I've came through the fire. You may not be able to stop, drop, and roll to smother the flame. But in your spiritual life, we need to stop, drop, and pray.
Yeah.
So the flame of life won't burn us too bad.
Yeah.
When it's all said and done, when the sin of this world has scarred us and gave us second and third degree burns, when it's all said and done and we've got so much pain and we have dealt with this fire of this world and we tried to put it out.
Yeah.
We tried to do the right thing.
Yeah.
We tried to pray. We tried to come to church. We tried to do the right thing, but it seems like every time we get into this pit of the fire, the better we try to act, the hotter it gets.
Yeah.
Well said.
Yes.
Take your time.
Oh, but when you can look down at the ashes,
yes, sir,
and the thing that tried to take your very life,
yes,
that test you have been going through for a while,
yes,
when it seemed like the fire just keep getting hotter and hotter,
yes,
when it seemed that you got so many scars,
yeah,
but you can look up towards heaven,
yeah,
maybe smelling like a little smoke,
yeah,
maybe your clothes have been singed a little bit,
yeah,
but because the devil didn't take your life,
yeah, right,
you can tell somebody,
yeah,
I made it through the fire.
Yeah.
In the Bible, there are many uses again for fire. In our biblical history, fire has been used to promote, to punish, and to persevere. There are many characters of the Bible that have used fire to do one of these three things. Remember in Exodus 3 where Moses was doing the job of his father-in-law.
Yeah.
But then he looked over and saw fire, bush being consumed by fire.
Yeah.
But what he couldn't understand was that the fire was not burning the bush.
Yes, sir.
See, God sometimes will use fire just to get our attention.
Yeah.
It doesn't necessarily mean that you did something bad.
Yeah.
It doesn't always mean that you've done something right.
Yeah.
Just every now and then the Lord will send some fire your way,
yeah,
just to get your attention.
Yeah.
Then down in Genesis 19, when Abraham pleaded for Sodom and Gomorrah,
yes,
the Lord said, Abraham said, if I could just find just a few righteous folks.
Yeah.
churches today. It's hard to find a few righteous folk. It's hard to find those that don't mind standing up for God. It's hard to find those that don't mind doing work for the Lord. It's even hard to find those who will do just what God has asked us to do. But the Bible says because they couldn't find righteous folks, that God used fire to rain down from heaven and destroy the city. I'm here to warn some of you today that if you don't find some righteous folks, if you don't start hanging around some good folks, if you keep doing what we do, we're going to find ourselves with fire consumed from God. Then over in Acts 2, as they was hanging out in the upper room, Bible says that fire on tongues came down from heaven. That tells me that sometime the Lord will use fire to get us in the spirit. Every now and then there's nothing wrong with having a good shout in the church. Every now and then there's nothing wrong with clapping your hands and doing a little dance every now and then. But some of us see the fire coming and we put it out before it enters the church. Oh, I wish I had somebody that don't mind bringing the fire with them to the church. I wish I had somebody that don't mind setting the church on fire. Because when you think about the goodness of Jesus and all that he's done for me, every now and then I got to set something on fire. And even in Deuteronomy, God calls himself fire. He said the Lord God is like a consuming fire. Just like some of us, fire isn't all bad. Just because you look different doesn't mean that you're defiant. Just because you may be poor doesn't mean you're proud. Just because you may be a little slow doesn't mean that you're a little crazy. But on the other hand, fire isn't always good. Just because you got a little money doesn't mean you got it made. Just because you got a nice car doesn't mean you got a nice attitude. Just because you look good on the outside doesn't mean you look good on the inside. Just because you know how to set fire on the outside doesn't mean you got fire on the inside. Jeremiah said it just like fire. Shut up in my bones. Some of us got some kids, but don't know how to set it on fire. If you want to learn how to set some things on fire, I dare you just to think about what God has brought you from. And you ain't got to worry about somebody striking the mat, because the Holy Spirit set it on fire. Regardless of how hot the flame, how much it burned, how many scars you had. Songwriter says, I've been through the fire.
That's right.
I've been through the flood. But through it all, I can make it through. to the biblical days. Let us return to King Nebuchadnezzar. And all of us are now under his leadership. King decided that he was going to construct a golden image. Bible is not clear if this image was of himself or of an idol god. But the purpose of the image was to erect a god-like being. So whenever they heard the music, whenever the church doors were open, whenever that Hammond B3 started playing, whenever the drummer started ripping, they were to stop whatever they was doing, fall down on their knees, and praise this idol image. But there's always something that starts some stuff started in the church. There's always something that goes against the grain of the church. There's always something or someone that always got something to say. Now if you're sitting beside that person, just keep looking forward. There was these three Hebrew boys who were in leadership roles under Nebuchadnezzar. And there was just Tattletale who went to the king and said, "King, these three boys that you have put in place to lead us is not doing what you say." The song played, the choir sing, the drummer played, the musicians played loudly, and they don't bow to the image.
Take your time.
So King got a little upset.
Yes.
Sent for the boy. Boys came to him and the king told him in a very nice manner, "You boys, I understand that you've been busy.
Yes.
I understand that I've gained you some responsibility.
Yes.
But when the music sounds, you're supposed to bow down and praise this image.
Yes.
So I'm going to give you a chance to bow down right now." Isn't it always something in the church?
Yes.
Somebody want to start some minutes. The thing is, the king said everybody else is doing it.
Yes.
How come you're not doing it?
Yes.
And it's for Sundays where I have to talk to my young people every now and then. Just because everybody else is doing it doesn't make it right. Just because the crowd goes along with what is wrong doesn't make it right. But these three boys stood boldly before the king. And they said, "King, we appreciate you. Thank you for what you're doing. But we're not going to bow down for any god except our God. We're not going to do the thing that you've asked us to do because we know who our God is." See, when you got God on your side, it doesn't matter who's against you. For my scripture says, if God be for you, he's more than the whole world against you. So now the king began to get angry. Because he was showed up in front of his people. He started to lose his swag. So the king said, "Punishment for this, you have to be thrown in the fire." king was so mad that he told him to turn up the heat seven times hotter. See, it's bad when you're in trouble, but it's really bad when you're really in trouble. You know, it's bad when mama and daddy say, come here, but when they call you by your full government name, you're really in trouble. Bible says, y'all still with me?
Yeah.
Bible says that they took the boys and they bounded them up. And these soldiers took them to the furnace. And when they opened the door of the furnace, the fire was so hot that the soldiers fell dead. Be careful, because the people that are trying to kill you, the same thing that they used to kill you, the Bible says what God has said for the devil has been for evil, God can turn that thing around and make it for his good. Okay, here we go. Here we go. They pushed the boys into the furnace. King thought that everything had been taken care of.
Yeah.
All of his people, all of his priests, all of his leaders, all of his presidents, all of his deacons, all of his choir members, all of his ushers were standing around, and he made a statement. He wanted to make a statement that if you cross me, I'll kill you. He wanted to make it known that if you don't like the things I'm doing, then you will burn in the fire.
Yeah.
There's a problem in our churches today. When we get so wrapped up in tradition that we lose focus on the purpose. When the preachers and pastors think now that they are God, and you either do what I say or you will burn. Can I help somebody today? Tradition will kill the church. That's another sermon. So here's what happened. Y'all still with me? They pushed him in the fire. And the king, with all of his people, he sat there. And he watched the flame. And then he looked. And then he got up and looked a little closer. And he called for the deacons. He called for the choir members. And he said, didn't I tell you to put those three boys in there? Bounded up so they can burn in the fiery furnace? And they said, yes, Master. That's what we did. Yes, Master. That's what we did. Well, how come I see a foreman in the fire, and they don't look like what they're going through? Somebody missed that. I see them in the fire, but they don't look like what they're going through. I'll try this side. He says, there's a fourth man, and he looks
Son of God. So he says, hey, come here. And here's what happened. The same fire that was used to punish was the same fire that God used to preach. The fire that the king used to punish these three boys was now used to minister to the king, because the scripture said when they walked out, they didn't even smell like smoke. When they walked out, they didn't have no birds on them. When they walked out, they didn't look like what they've been through. So that tells me that they've been through the fire. They wasn't consumed by the fire. They weren't taken in by the fire. But they've been through the fire. And the scripture says that the king got saved. I don't mind working hard today. The situations in your life may not be for you. All the hell you're going through may not be for you. But see, God knows how much you can bear. And every now and then, he needs you to help somebody else get saved. Every now and then, so somebody else won't get burned. Can I just be real? He needs you to go through hell to keep some folks out of hell. And the story goes that the fourth man who was in the fire, all the fourth man who was in the fire, the one, when they went in the fire, they were bound. But when the fourth man got in the fire, they were loose. When you're going through the fire, you may be bound by sickness. Before they went in the fire. Now this is the same God that created the heavens, that created the moon, that created all of creation. He could have went before they pushed him in, but he didn't do it. He could have waited until they got out, but he didn't do it. Yeah. the same man who they thought was dead is now alive and he's well. The fourth man, praise his name, was in the fire. Why are you going through? You make it burn. It may hurt. Folks may call you all kind of names, but just wait on the fourth man. You know, in baseball, they put the best hitters at fourth. So the first one can get on first base. Second one hit the ball, and you got two men on base. The third guy hits the ball, and you got three men on base. And then when the fourth man steps up in the box, he can knock it out. And that's what they call a grand slam. That tells me that while I'm going through the first day, I may have to run the first. I may lose. The second day, I may have some friends talk about me. The third day, I may got some bills I can't pay. The door of the church.